on to the next exciting adventure in complex numbers, which is going to be multiplying them. Multiplying complex numbers. And look how excited we are. We can hardly contain ourselves. All right. Multiplying complex numbers. Not too bad, but we have to start out with an aside. And that is this. All right. We talked about I is equal to the square root of negative 1. Not a problem, right? We also said that I squared is equal to negative 1. So here's a question. What's I cubed? Well, because I'm fantastically algebraic, I can write that it's the same thing as I times I squared. Remember? Because I kind of has this little secret 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. Here's my 3. Okay, so that's algebraically equivalent. So I to the first is just I. And then I squared is, we just wrote it, negative 1. So in fact, I cubed is equal to negative I. I times negative 1, negative I. I to the fourth now. That's equivalent to, if I wrote it like this, I squared times I, what would this number need to be here? Think about it. 2 plus what is 4? Yay! 2. Okay. Let me get excited. I squared is negative 1. This other I squared is negative 1. Negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. Yay! 1. Okay. Now what's actually kind of neat is this. Alright. So this is the biggest thing you want to worry about. And actually, you only kind of need to memorize these first two, because everything else you can derive from that, because we just did it. So if I had I to the fifth, I could write that as, let's see, as I to the fourth times what? Times I just to the first, right? Because 4 plus 1 is 5. So I could say I to the fourth is, I got it up here, 1. And then I to the first is just I. So, I times 1 is I. I to the 6th is I. I'm going to do I to the 4th times I to the what? What? 4 plus what is 2? Wait, 4 plus, I just said it. 4 plus what is 6? 2! I am an adding master. So, I to the 4th again is still 1. Nothing's changed. But what's I squared? Negative 1. Yep. So, negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. Now, the same thing's going to happen here. I to the fourth times I. Probably seeing a pattern here, maybe. I to the fourth is 1. I cubed is what? Negative I. We did it right here. So, negative I times 1 is negative I. Then I to the eighth is going to be I to the fourth times I to the fourth, which is equal to 1. The other I to the 4th, is that equal to 1? Yep. Sure is. So 1 times 1 is 1. So you might see a pattern. We've got I, negative 1, negative I, 1. I, negative 1, negative I, 1. And in fact, I to the 9th is I to the 10th is negative 1. I to the 11th is negative I. And I to the 12th is 1. Follows the same pattern. So this is kind of one of those fun party tricks that you can do, because you can say, I know what I to the 382nd is, and you can go from there. But anyway, it's just kind of fun to play with. But this all becomes important now when we talk about how to multiply complex numbers. So we're going to scroll down here and actually look at this stuff. So again, we're going to go back to a more standard example that we would know just from algebra. So let's try this. 4x times 3 minus 5x. See how that takes you. So hopefully this isn't too weird. You say, oh yeah, I need to distribute. So I've got 4x times 3 is 12x. 4x times negative 5x minus 20x squared, and I'm done. Alright, so you're going to see a relation now to what we do with imaginary numbers. So we've got 4i times 3 minus 5i. So again, you want to draw a parallel to something that you do know how to do to try to help figure out something that maybe you don't know how to do. So this looks kind of similar, right? So you might think, well, let me just go ahead and distribute and see what happens. Alright, so 4i times 3 would be 12i. 4i times negative 5i would be negative 20i squared. Now this squared is important, right? Because I have I times I. I times I is I squared. I times I is I squared, right? So I'm not done now. Here's the thing. Here I was done. Here I'm not done. Not done. And so what I need to do is I need to say, okay, well, I got 12i minus 20, and then I squared is equal to, right, negative 1. So I've got 12i minus 20 times negative 1 plus 20. Now I want to rewrite it in standard form. Standard form. So to get it into standard form, I need to rewrite it as the real part first, then the imaginary part. And that works. All right. So we'll do a couple more examples. We'll do, let's do 7i times 2 minus 9i. So I've got my 7i distributes across. So 7i times 2 is 14i. 7i minus 9i times minus 9i, negative. 7 times 9 is 63. I times I is I squared. So I keep going. I squared is the same thing as negative 1. So 14i, negative 63 times negative 1 is plus 63. And again, to rewrite it in standard form, I put the real part first, and then the imaginary part. And it's really, honest to goodness, as straightforward as that. Now again, anything that we expect you to do in terms of algebra, we can expect you to do in terms of imaginary numbers. So if you'll remember how to solve something like this, which is regular stuff. So 7 minus 3x, negative 2 plus 5x. Okay. Remember how to do this? What do we call this method? Call it the FOIL method. First adder in or last. So first is going to be chunk, chunk, negative 14. Outer, chunk, chunk, positive 7 times 5x, 35x. Inner, chunk, chunk. So negative 3x times negative 2 plus 6x. And then last, chunk, chunk. Negative 3x times 5x plus 15x squared. We can combine like terms a little bit. Get negative 14 plus 41x plus 15x squared. That's not too bad. Now, as you might guess, we can do this with imaginary numbers. Let's say we had this. Similar problem, 7 minus 3i, negative 2 plus 5i. And so we wanted to simplify that. Again, we're going to use the FOIL method. First, 7 times negative 2, negative 14. Outer, 7 times 5i, 35i. Inner, negative 3i times negative 2, plus 6i. Last, negative 3i times 5i, minus 15 times I is I squared. Again, I'm just going to keep going. I'm not going to worry about what comes next. I'm just going to go one step at a time. Be careful that you don't forget this square term, because for some reason, people just get really, really excited about the fact that they got everything right so far, and then they get to this last step, and they totally forget to put that squared there, and it makes absolutely all the difference in the world. So definitely watch out for that. So we got negative 14 plus 35i plus 6i plus 41i. We have minus 15, and I squared is equal to negative 1. So I've got negative 14 plus 41i, negative 15 times negative 1 plus 15. And then I've got negative 14 plus 15 gives me 1. And then plus 41i. Reasonable? Let me make that look prettier. 41i.